Good morning, everyone. It's so wonderful to see so many people dressed up for their school pictures today and their Sunday best. You guys are looking sharp, looking sharp. I see lots of spring colors today. Today is Wednesday, March the 24th, and I'm excited to have two helpers here today from Mrs. McCreary's class. I have Georgia and Naraya here to help us with the pledges. Please stand and join us.
Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will hide its words in my heart that I might not sin against God.
Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing for our time of praise and worship today.
Higher than the sky, your love
It's you. Dear Jesus, thank you. You are a good Father.
Yes, Jesus.
We tell you this morning that we love you and we thank you for loving us.
Yes, Jesus.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
You can be seated and welcome to chapel.
Oh, you guys look so awesome.
Yes, you do.
You're your Sunday best. It was so fun to see some of you guys even just coming in this morning. I only saw a peek, but seeing you guys come into chapel, I was like, they look so nice.
That's right. I love it.
So cute.
So we are going to continue our series. You remember what the theme is? That's right. Playing on God's team. We're talking about baseball. We're going to talk more about the disciples, the people who followed Jesus while he was here on earth. Before spring break, Miss Patton taught us about someone had trouble being loyal. Do you remember his name? Shout it out if you do.
Judas.
Very good.
Nice.
You guys have a good memory from before spring break. That's right. That seemed like
it was so long ago. A couple times.
Yeah, that's right.
That's awesome. Well, today we are actually going to be learning about John. And, you know, we're talking about how they compare to baseball. So John in the Bible is kind of like a pinch hitter in baseball. And I know some of you guys play baseball, and so you understand what I'm talking about, but a pinch hitter is somebody that comes in and substitute while a guy's up to bat, and that guy, they send him in, and he actually comes in and, like, hopefully gets a home run.
That's right.
And he's, like, super duper dependable. Like, they know they can count on this guy.
Mm-hmm.
And so John in the Bible, Jesus knew that he could count on his disciple John. And so I think that's really good, because being dependable,
so important.
So important.
So important.
It is so important to have that characteristic and to really, truly be dependable, especially when God calls on you to do something.
But Ms. Kimber, before we get started, I want to try a little trick.
Okay.
We're going to demonstrate dependability. Okay. I need one volunteer, somebody that's not afraid to try something new. Let's see. It's so hard. Sometimes it's hard to get people in the back. So let's see. Miss Watts, I know. I'm sorry I caught you while you were coughing. Would you send someone up here to help us? Someone back there in the back. All right, Mr. Judson, come on up. Judson Boney, give him a hand. We need you right back here. So Judson, our challenge for you today, you've got a cup of water and an empty cup. I would like you to transfer that water from this cup to that cup using the straw, but you cannot use your mouth. You can't suck the water up and spit it back in. You have to just transfer with just your hands and the straw. Can you do it?
Can you guys see him?
What could it work? What could work? You have any ideas? You think you know?
I think it won't.
Oh, you think it won't? What could we do? Wesley, you got an idea? Try that. Put your finger on top of the straw. Let's see if it works, Mr. Wesley.
It's spilled. Well, try it again.
Try it again. Suction it good. Yep.
Oh,
we got some in there. But it's getting on the stand. The idea is working. It's true. Yeah, get it completely covered. See, no air coming.
There you go.
There you go.
It's filling up, guys.
It's working. So that would take a while to transfer all that water, right? Can you guys see over here? So Judson, you are doing an excellent job, and I'm going to let you stop because you've got the idea, right? It's working, but that would take you a long time to do that.
Right.
So why do you think that works? Wesley, you had the idea. You give us the answer. You don't know? Okay. Okay.
And why is that? Why does it do that?
He's saying there can't be empty space. So when you hold this, that suction holds the water in. But when I release my finger,
it drops out
because of
gravity.
Very good.
Nice
thank
job.
You, Judson, for being
that
our help.
That is awesome.
Yes, thank you. Gravity. Let's try one more thing with this ball. Make sure that gravity works at all times, okay? So if Miss Kimber throws it up, it does come down, right? If you throw it all the way over here to me, will it come down, do you think? It did. Gravity.
Nice job.
Could we say that gravity works? You would all agree? Gravity is dependable?
Yes.
Right? I would agree. And you know, gravity is what keeps the earth and us on the earth. It keeps our feet on the ground.
Keeps us planted.
Keeps us planted.
Yep.
What would happen if there was no gravity here? Yes, sir. We would float into outer space.
We would all be high-fiving each other in the air right now. Actually, no, because of social distancing. We would stay 6 feet apart in the air.
Elbow in the sky.
Yes.
Yeah, so who's thankful for gravity? Well, some of you want to be floating in the sky.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. But what would happen, too, if you were to jump up? What would happen? You're going to come back down. But what if you jumped as hard as you could? What would happen? You're still going to come back down.
Yeah. Even if you try really hard.
Even if you are on that trampoline and you are jumping as hard as you can, you're going to come back down.
You're going to come back down.
You're going to come back down.
Right. Yes. Gravity is dependable. And you know what? Dependability is so important for us to have. It's a very important characteristic.
Yes.
It's one that we can learn from John because he was very dependable.
Yes.
Very, very dependable.
And you know, even whenever we're waking up in the morning, how many of us had to depend on an alarm clock this morning to wake up?
Mm-hmm.
Me.
Mm-hmm.
And how many of you guys depended on your parents to come in there and say, hey, it's picture day. You need to get up. You got to take a shower.
Mm-hmm.
Yep,
mm-hmm.
We depended on our parents to wake us up because that's something that we think about in the morning.
I depended on my car to start this morning.
Yes.
I would have been in a world of hurt had
I depended it not. On my coffee this morning to wake me up, okay? So we have to, we depend on different things. And if a friend says, hey, I'm going to meet you at this time, we're going to go to Chick-fil-A. You depend
Chick-fil-A,
on them. You want them
course.
To come and meet you there,
that's right?
Right.
We want dependable
Or they say, meet
friends.
Me on the playground.
Dependable friends are good,
yes.
right?
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
We need dependability in our life. And you know what? Whenever Jesus called John, he called his brother as well. And they were some of Jesus's best friends.
That's right.
They were super close. I mean, they did a lot of things together. And John and Jesus, they had a good relationship.
Mm-hmm.
And Jesus could depend on John. And that was really, really important. He was around when he performed miracles.
That's right. Let's think of some of the things that John saw or that Jesus asked him to do. So John did see a lot of miracles because he was with him every day, right?
Yep.
He walked with him. He saw the things that he did. Do you remember when Jesus went up on the mountain and he was transfigured or he was changed into his heavenly glory? There were some people up there that saw him and John was one of
Whoa.
Them. That was a special occasion.
That's really,
Not
really
all of
cool.
the disciples got to go, but John was one of those. Do you remember that?
Yes, mm-hmm. that was really, really awesome. And you know, even on the day that Jesus was arrested, John and another disciple were there. And they were there and they were right there with him, even though it was super risky. Mm-hmm. And then whenever they had the last Passover meal, do you know who got to go help prepare all of that? John.
That's right.
That's
Jesus
cool.
Jesus said, John, go and get the room ready.
Yeah.
Go do it.
Take care of it. Mm-hmm. And he knew that if anything were to happen, that he could depend on John, which is so cool.
That's right. So these examples tell us that John was dependable. Jesus knew that he could say, John, go and do this. John, come and see this. John, come and pray with me here. And he knew that John wouldn't say, I don't want to do that. No, that's boring. No, that's too tough.
I don't feel like
it today.
Yep.
Yeah.
I'm tired.
Mm-mm.
I don't want to do that.
Mm-mm.
He knew.
He knew.
Mm-hmm.
He knew who he could trust. He knew who he could depend on. And John was one of those.
Yes. And even, you know, how he was with Jesus when he was being arrested, like, that's super risky. He followed right behind him. And even when Jesus was on the cross, he was thinking about his mom.
Mm-hmm.
And guess who he asked to take care of his mother when he was going to be gone? John. Let's actually read that together. Because we're coming up to Holy Week, and we're coming up to Easter when Jesus died on the cross for our sins. And so these are super important for us to know, like, all the background stories of leading up to it. Because we've heard many times that Jesus died on the cross for your sins. But to know the background story and to know all these disciples or who was walking with him along the way, it kind of gives us a better understanding of what all was happening at that time, right? Okay, so it says, but standing by the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing nearby, John, he said to his mother, woman, behold your son. And then he said to the disciple, John, behold your mother. And from that hour, the disciple took her to his own home.
So he was going to treat her as his own mother.
Wow.
And she was going to treat him
like a son.
Like a son. So that's a big honor.
Yes.
If someone were to ask you to take care of their mother,
that's a big deal.
That's a big deal.
That is a
big deal. Because they want someone that's dependable and trustworthy and someone that is going to do a good job.
Yes.
And take care of their loved one.
I love
that.
That's
a big deal. But 3 days later, when Jesus rose from the dead and the women came and saw the empty tomb, do you know, they ran and told the disciples, you know who one of the first persons to get there to see the empty tomb was?
John. You guys are so smart.
That's right. So he was there and he saw Jesus perform miracles. He saw him when he was arrested and he followed to see what was happening. He saw him die on the cross. He accepted the ask of taking care of his mother. He saw him in his heavenly glory. He saw him praying in the Garden of Gethsemane.
Gosh, that is amazing.
He was right there.
He was
at so many important times.
And he was such a dependable friend. And John was so dependable because he made the decision to love Jesus and to follow him. And then he stuck to it, even when things got really hard, even when he was getting arrested, even when there was like super risky business, John was right there. He didn't leave his side. He knew that God was important and he wanted to stay close to him and he wanted to be his friend. And I think that is awesome because I can learn from that.
Right.
To be a dependable person,
right.
To make sure I'm honoring my friends and honoring my parents and being dependable when I'm asked to do something, by doing it well, not just doing it just kind of willy-nilly, but doing it well and with excellence, because that shows my character and
that's
that
right.
I'm trying to honor Jesus as well and be dependable.
The Bible says in Colossians 3:17, whatever you do, whatever you do, whether it's in words you speak or in things you do, it says indeed, do it all in the name of the Lord. So whatever you say, whatever you do, whether it's with your words or your actions, do it as if you're doing it for the Lord. When you're helping your brother or your sister or your mom or your dad or your grandma or your grandpa or your teacher or your the person that sits next to you in school, whatever you do, help them to the best of your ability. Do your work to the best of your ability, because that brings honor and glory to Jesus. Because you're his child. You're his child. And he loves you so much. And when you do things to the best of your ability, as if you're doing it to the Lord, you are praising him and honoring him when you're doing it.
Isn't that so cool?
It is so awesome.
I love that.
And being dependable, not only, you know, many of us have asked Jesus to live in our heart. And being dependable means we don't quit. We don't stop. When Jesus asks us to do something, when he asks us to care for our friend, or he asks us to do whatever it is, we say yes.
Yes.
We're dependable, just like John was. We say yes and do it, even if it may seem scary. Or it may seem boring.
Yep. Like, I really don't want to do that. But you know what? I said that I was going to do that. I'm going to be dependable, and I'm going to keep my word.
So being dependable to Jesus and also being dependable to our friends and our family members. Mm-hmm. When we say we're going to do something, we
do it.
Do it.
Yes.
That's right. We do it. We follow through. We do it. So our big idea today is I can be dependable to Jesus and to others. Can you say that with us?
I can be dependable to Jesus and to others. Yes.
Very good.
I love that. Pastor Brenda, those were such great examples too. We can be dependable to grandma, grandpa, to our teachers. We can speak up for what's right. Mm-hmm. Whenever there's somebody that is, you know, not being treated very fairly or kindly, you can speak up and say, hey, you know what? That person is a child of God. Let's not speak mm-hmm. to them that way. We are created. The Lord loves us, and we don't need to speak that way. You can stand up for your friends.
I'm just curious. I have a question. Has anybody in this room, I want you to raise your hand, if you've ever seen someone mistreated by another person? I think we all, look at that. We all have seen that happen. All of us. So when we see it happen, we can speak up.
Yes.
We can speak up for that person. It could be on the playground. It could be in the classroom. It could be at home. It could be at the park. It could be so many places. But we can speak up. That is so awesome.
Yes, I love that. Because God loves us all mm-hmm. so much. And he's looking for people who will serve him no matter mm-hmm. what. Even when things get hard. Even when things get tricky and risky or even boring. We can serve God no matter what. Can you imagine if we all together as a school and as a community and whenever we go out, we were dependable people and we served mm-hmm. and honored God with everything that we did, just like our memory verse. If we honored God with everything that we did, can you imagine what our community would be like?
Do you think it would be a little bit different? Do you think mm-hmm. we could make a change?
Mm-hmm.
I think so. Yeah. I think so, because you know what? Good deeds, acts of kindness, acts of being dependable.
Yep.
It spreads.
It does.
It spreads. Mm-hmm. So your good deed could lead to someone else doing a good deed. Your being dependable could lead to your friend being dependable.
Yeah.
You acting like Jesus, showing the love of Jesus, can have them actually accept Jesus.
Isn't
and then
cool?
they're showing Jesus to other people.
That's so cool.
It changes. It changes the world.
And we can be just like John. And be that dependable mm-hmm. friend, right?
That's yes. right. Okay, Miss Kimber, would you close us in prayer?
Absolutely. Lord, I just thank you for bringing us back together today for chapel, Lord Jesus. I thank you for protecting us over spring break and even just bringing us here today, Lord Jesus. Lord, thank you for opening up our hearts today as we've learned about John and about being a dependable person, Lord. I ask that you would just help us as we go in and finish this week, Lord, that you give us opportunities to be dependable and to keep our hearts right before you, Jesus. So, Lord, I ask that you would change our hearts to be more like you, that you would bless us and give us favor. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I'm so impressed with Judson's skills. Judson, that's a part of our science lesson for today. So good job, bud. You've gotten us off to a good start. Judson's raising the roof back there. I like it. I wanted to let you guys know a few announcements. First of all, there's some new artwork that's been selected by some of the teachers to be hung up in my office. So I had the chance to give out certificates to 3 students yesterday, and I think we may have some pictures to put up there. 3 pieces of artwork were selected without the teachers knowing whose artwork it was, kind of a blind selection. I'm excited to say I have artwork from Evan Campbell, Hudson Lyons, and Eric Jones that are in my office for the next month or so. So I'm really excited to have that. And if you want to bring your class over and pop in my office, you can take a look at those. But each of these guys and girl did a wonderful job, and I'm excited to have those on display, especially when I have visitors in my office. I love to have sometimes new families that may be coming to Bethesda next year, and when they come in my office to meet me and get to know more about the school, I love to be able to show them, hey, this is what our kids are doing in the art class. It's a wonderful display of your work. So I hope to see yours in my office sometime soon. Next week is an exciting week. Sunday is Palm Sunday. There's some special activities happening up here at the Kids Ministry if you want to be a part of that. I know that they're also handing out resurrection eggs this weekend, I think, is the last opportunity to pick those up. We are having a special Easter drive-through on Tuesday and Wednesday night. And 3rd, 4th, and 5th grade, you are the cast members. So just like we heard today from Colossians 3:17, whatever you do in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord. And on Tuesday and Wednesday night, we're not doing something in word so much because that's going to be recorded for people to listen to in their cars as they drive through. But each of you is going to have a deed to do. You may be waving palm leaves to show Palm Sunday. You might be pretending to drink from a cup at the Lord's Supper. At the Last Supper, you may be pretending to hold a sword and a shield if you're one of the soldiers, but I'd ask that each of you think about your role that you're playing, that part of the Easter story. It's absolutely the greatest story ever told, and we want to be able to share that with our community. So I'm looking forward to seeing you guys there. As a special treat, next week we will be celebrating Easter parties on Thursday. So just like we did at Christmas time, we invited parents up to come for the reindeer run. On Thursday of next week, Coach Rob is planning some special games and activities during your regular PE time, and we'll be playing those out in the area close to the soccer field, and we'll invite parents who want to join us during your PE time. They can come up and watch some of those games that are happening outdoors. So those are all of the announcements that I have for today. When Easter parties are over with, we will enjoy a four-day weekend for Easter. It's a wonderful time to celebrate and to remember the sacrifice that Christ made for each of us. I hope that you have a wonderful day and do a great job with Picture Day. Teachers, if your class is going to have pictures made, they are next door in the youth lounge today. So everybody smile bright, show the joy of the Lord on your face when you get your picture made. Have a great day. Bye-bye.